thank you, Victoria, for the introduction. So, first of all, I need to transmit the greetings from our Romanian Association of Fracture Mechanics to our colleagues from Italian Group of Fracture. You have more history, more experience than us. We are younger, probably half of the age that your association. And I can say that you are a good model for us to follow. The title of the paper is Mixed Mode Fracture Toughness of Particle Board, and the paper was elaborated with one of my former students and Dr. Octavian Pop, who is from Université de Limoges in the Eglinton campus in France. So the summary of the presentation, I will start with a short introduction. I will present our experimental program, which consists in three-point bending test, mode 1 fracture toughness test, predominantly mode 2 fracture toughness test, some digital image correlation measurements, energy evaluation, and finally some conclusions. So the particle boards are wooden-based composite with fine wood fibers bound together by a small amount of polymeric adhesive, widely used in furniture industry and civil engineering. So one of my graduate students went to work to the company, one of the biggest companies producing furniture in our area. So I have a funny story. The stories of Professor Chiara were quite horrible because there were quite a lot of damages. So the story of this is that the owner of this company is one of the sponsors of our football team, which unfortunately relegates Saturday in the second division. So, but he is a good friend with our rector, and so they arrange. So in Romania, this is one of the way to work. So by friendship, and then I need to do some tests for them. Anyway, enhance quite many failure on the fabrication and then on the furniture that they sell it, and there were observed different types of failure, a mode 1 failure and let's say a mode 2 or mixed mode failures on the particle board panels. So what they need some, let's say, some design data in order to have the modulus of rupture, the fracture toughness, in order to, let's say, avoid from design some failures. On the other hand, there are quite a lot of scatter in the fracture toughness of particle and medium density MDF, medium density fiber boards at that time, and only few data are related to mixed mode fracture and mode 2 fracture toughness. So what we did, so we use two thickness of panels of particle board, 60 millimeter thickness and 25 millimeter thickness. They were very close in density. It is known that density is a very important parameter in mechanical behavior of this, but the density is more or less the same, so in the let's say experimental determination limit. The humidity of the panels were around 65%. We performed the test in our strength of materials laboratory on a 5 kN maximum load testing machine. We use a displacement control of 10 millimeter per minute. We performed the tests at room temperature. And I mentioned, we use a Dantex system for digital image correlation measurements. So the three-point bending tests were done. We use a square cross section for the beams that we tested. Here there are some low displacement There are some low displacement curves, so for 25 millimeter cross width and thickness and for 15 millimeter. So it could be seen that it's a, let's say, quasi-brittle behavior of these materials in bending test. So we calculate as the community using wood mostly, they say modulus of rupture and modulus of elasticity as us, but they use this term instead of the strength, the bending strength. So we test this on two positions, so the normal position in which works the panels, but sometimes they use the part of the panels on this position. So we did the bending test for two types of position and for two different thicknesses of the specimens. So what we saw that for 60 millimeter panel we get higher modulus of rupture and higher modulus of elasticity, and then compared with the 25 millimeter, and the higher strength of the higher modulus of rupture was when we put the specimens in position one as they usually work. So the same was observed for the modulus of elasticity. So we can provide them, so the values are around 10 megapascal square meters, 11.5 the biggest one, and 9.24 the lowest one for the modulus of rupture, and the modulus of elasticity is around 1.7, 1.5 gigapascals. So we provide them this data, and we start our fracture test program. So we use for the mode 1 fracture toughness single edge bend notch bend specimen as usual. Here the thickness of the plate was the thickness of the specimen, so 16 and 25 millimeter, and you can see here our Dantec digital image correlation system with the lighting system and the two cameras. So some typical low displacement curves obtained during the mode 1 fracture toughness test. It could be seen that is not any more brittle behavior here. Anyhow, we use the maximum load from here in order to estimate the mode 1 fracture toughness with a normal relation. What we get here, so the other way around, so the maximum fracture toughness has the specimen with the thickness of 25 millimeters, and the values of the K1C are 0.8, 0.89 megapascal square meter. The predominantly mode 2 tests were done in compact shear specimens, so we work before on this type of specimens, and we show that this type of specimen did not produce pure mode 2, so it's a small amount of mode 1, so it's a predominantly mode 2 load. Again, we use the thickness of the two panels to manufacture the specimens, and the value of this effective, let's say, effective K, which is the square between K1 plus K2 at power 2. So the values of the effective specimen factor are lower than the mode 1 fracture toughness. And we also try to see if these materials are not homogeneous materials, they have these particles inside, but we try to see if the let's say the criteria, the fracture criteria are fitting the results. So we get much spread of results for pure mode 1 test, and I can say a better grouping of the experimental results for the predominantly mode 2 criteria loading, and I from looking on the criteria, apparently the maximum tensile stress and the minimum strain energy density give the better prediction of the fracture of this type of materials. So then we move to digital image correlation. So the surface of the specimens were covered with a black paint and with some white speckles. The displacement field can be obtained by comparing the reference image with the deformed image. So on this regard, so some parts of the specimens were delimited by a zone of interest, and this was divided in some subsets, and the displacement field is given by the displacement vector from the center of this subset to the center of the subset in the deformed stage. Let's say maybe we can do a similarity with the finite element method, so this can be considered either the nodes or either the integration point, the displacement of the middle of the specimen. So I will not enter in too much detail. So our colleague Dr. Pop has some publications on using digital image correlation and extracting the data by comparing the experimental displacement field with an equivalent displacement, theoretical displacement field. They use an adjustment procedure based on the Newton-Raphson, and they propose a crack relative displacement factor. So basically to estimate the energy release rate, which in classical fracture mechanics is K1 at power 2 divided by Young modulus, because these materials are not isotropic. So they use this methodology previously on some woods which are orthotropic or anisotropic materials, and they get quite good results. So we use their procedure, and finally the energy release rate can be defined multiplying the crack relative displacement with the K1, and we don't need to know the Young modulus. So for using this and looking on the energy, so the total energy for the single edge notch band specimen, so it's much higher to the elastic energy, which let's say indicates that the use of the K1 is not perfectly correct. So for MODU, for compact shift specimens, the difference between them is not so high. So the energy that comes with this let's say algorithm take into account also the fracture process zone, which is evident to mode one loading, and we calculate this energy release rate using this optical method. To conclude, we did some experimental evaluation of the mechanical and fracture properties for particle board, let's say bending mode 1 and predominantly mode 2 fracture toughness test. We use a coupling between experimental and analytical approach to determine the energy release rate. So this was based on calculating using digital image correlation of the crack relative displacement factor, and using the stress intensity factor, so we can have the fracture energy without knowing the Young modulus, the property of the material. What I would like to say here, if we divide the K1C to the effective fracture toughness that comes from the predominantly mode 2 test, the difference were between around 20%. Or when we compare the energies, the difference is quite high. So it's 85% between them. So this means that here we lost the fracture process zone part. So this process can be this approach can be further applied to real particle bond structures. So thank you very much for your attention.